In the search for more privacy in your digital life, it is of course best to keep your personal data as close as possible. If you really think about it, it seems almost careless to upload sensitive information like calendars, photos, contacts, documents, even passwords to other people's servers somewhere across the globe. Yet that is the case for billions of internet users, myself included. If you told people 25 years ago, everyone would freely share intimate secrets with global advertising corporations in exchange for free services, they would probably call you insane. Since I bought a Raspberry Pi, one of those credit card-sized mini-computers, I've got more into self-hosting some services I would have previously outsourced. Self-hosting ensures that your data stays with you, and you even have full control over it. I get that not everyone is able to self-host, but as I mentioned, you don't need to own a full-sized server. A single board computer like the Raspberry Pi is already enough in many cases. It is much smaller and consumes significantly less power than a desktop PC. Before we get into what are currently my favorite self-hosted apps, I want to add that I recommend not to open up ports in your router for outside access to your server. Most of the time you will probably use it in your home network anyway. And if you really need outside access, I recommend trying a personal VPN solution to connect to your home network. Many routers nowadays have such a feature, and it is much more secure than running a public server on the internet. I'd also advise you to not switch everything immediately. I would always first test the reliability of your self-hosting setup for a few weeks and make frequent backups before switching completely. The last thing you want is losing your data with no backups. Anyway, let's start with number 5 of my favorite self-hosted apps for Raspberry Pi. It's called Wallabag, and it is basically a read it later archiving service. I used to use Pocket and Instapaper a lot, but why save your articles on their servers when there is no need to? Wallabag extracts the article content to read offline for later reading and can even import from other popular archiving services. It has a browser add-on for quick saving and a mobile app for smartphones and some e-readers. You can tag and favorite articles to build your own archive. Wallabag even generates an RSS feed for your items. On the downside, I always found it to be rather sluggish and outdated. Not only visually, but it also receives few updates. In my opinion, their iOS app desperately needs a major update because it feels obsolete regarding design and performance. Like many open source projects, it is developed by a very small team though, so I am thankful they offer self-hosting for free. Number 4 on my list is the RSS reader FreshRSS. I am very happy with this app. It is super fast, even with hundreds of articles. It's responsive, meaning it even adapts to smartphone screens, and it is just well designed. It even has keyboard shortcuts and offers different themes and extensions to customize. Since Google Reader was discontinued in 2013, I've been looking for alternatives. I know many internet users don't even use RSS feeds anymore and instead get news from social media, but I like to have everything in one place in a universal format and no algorithms sorting my feed. I've used Comma Feed a few years and I liked it, but when I found FreshRSS, I decided to just self-host the reader. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a dedicated mobile app, but it is supported by popular RSS feed apps like Reader. Next is number 3, a self-hosted password manager. When I first started using password managers around a decade ago, I started with LastPass. I would still recommend it over no password manager at all, but the regular security incidents and the closed-source cloud-based approach made me increasingly uncomfortable. Then I tried out the open-source offline manager KeePass. Yes, I know many people love it, and I used it for a few years, but unfortunately it has that clunky, dull design many community open-source programs seem to have. And from syncing passwords to browser extensions and mobile apps, everything appeared to be a half-baked compromise, while commercial password managers seemed well-designed and easy to use. Thankfully, I found Bitwarden, my number 3 on this list. It is open source like KeePass, but in my opinion it offers a way better usability for regular users and a browser extension, desktop and mobile app and a web interface. It syncs to all my devices, yet I don't have to send my precious passwords anywhere. The self-hosted web interface is excellent for devices that don't have the Bitwarden app installed, another advantage over KeePass. Bitwarden can do everything most password managers can, like generating passwords and phrases, reports about reused, compromised, and weak passwords, sorting logins in folders, and two-factor authentication. At number 2, we have Nextcloud. Even some people who aren't self-hosting have probably heard about this very popular alternative to cloud hosters like Dropbox or Google Drive. I use it not only to store and sync files between devices, it is also my replacement for Google Calendar and syncs with the Tasks app on my phone. It is fairly well developed and can be extended by a large number of extensions. The phone app can even auto-upload pictures from your phone after they're taken. Nextcloud is certainly the most complex app I self-host, and it requires the appropriate amount of storage for your files. An external drive for your Raspberry Pi might be necessary. Corporate users can make use of the chat and conferencing features and share calendars, files, contacts, and more. Nextcloud has a large community and is used and supported by organizations around the world. I don't think it has any major weak spots in terms of usability and features, but I'd like to see end-to-end encryption finally released. That feature has been in development for years, and it's one of the small things I'm missing. I've had a few crashes with the sync clients for Windows and Mac OS, but overall I'm happy with the quality of the Nextcloud software. The final self-hosted app on number 1 is actually one of the least noticeable in everyday use, and technically not hosting much. It's Pi-hole, the sole reason why many people get a Raspberry Pi. Pi-hole is a DNS filter for advertisements and malicious websites. It protects the entire network instead of devices with individual browser plugins. That means it also works on phones, in apps, and on smart TVs. Any device using Pi-hole as its DNS server can take advantage. It is very lightweight and displays a neat overview over the queries and clients handled. When you log in, you can view the query log and change white and blacklist settings. Pi-hole has different privacy settings, and if you're not the only person using it, I strongly recommend asking all users if they are comfortable with all their access domains being logged. I personally would set the DNS resolver to anonymous and disable all access logs. Usually it is not necessary to log queries all the time anyway, and you can still view the anonymous statistics on the homepage. Once it is set up, you can usually leave Pi-hole alone and just use your devices like normal. Be aware that a filter based on domains like Pi-hole is not able to catch all ads, and some websites like YouTube provide content from the same domains as ads, so it doesn't work there as well. You could even set it up for non-techies like your grandparents, because it is so low maintenance and unintrusive. These are my favorite self-hosted apps for Raspberry Pi right now. If you're wondering, I don't currently self-host my email, because I think the risk of technical issues and missing important emails is just too big for me. Maybe someday. Let me know in the comments of this video if I missed anything, or if there's another app I should check out.